Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. With me right now is Leslie Klein, CEO at CECOM Satellite Systems. Leslie, it's good to meet you. How are you today?
I'm very well. Thank you for having me, Christine. It's a pleasure to meet you over the internet.
Yes, it's great to have you here. Leslie, start us off with giving us an introduction into the company.
I started CECOM in 1997. So the company has been in business for 24 years. And it has been profitable for about 17 consecutive years. Since then, other than last year, was the first time we had a very slight loss because of the pandemic, of course. But the company went public in 2001. We raised about $5 million. And since that time, the company has never gone back for money. It has been profitable. It has about $24 million of working capital. It pays dividends. It has paid out over $16 million in dividends, and it has zero debt. So that's basically the financial aspect of the company. We are developing and designing some interesting products. We have customers in over 106 countries, and we have deployed the antenna systems that we're developing in 106 countries. And we have about 8,500 of these antennas working all around the world. And we use resellers to sell our products in those countries.
Now, speaking about some of your products, I understand you're developing something called a Ka band. Can you describe that to us?
Yeah, we are developing a Ka band electronically steered phased array antenna. Satellite antennas generally are parabolic antennas that sit in a fixed position, and they don't move. Once you set it up, generally speaking, they are locked to a geostationary satellite, which is about 36,000 kilometers overhead, and it rotates with the rotation of the Earth. So the antenna is always in a fixed position. With the advent of the new LEO or low Earth orbit satellites, these antennas would no longer function properly because the satellites are moving and the antenna would have to track these moving satellites. So we have developed with the University of Waterloo in Canada an electronically steered antenna that is presently being tested over satellite that actually tracks a moving satellite, and will make it also possible for you to drive or fly or be on a, in a marine environment and move while the antenna is moving on a car or a plane, and the satellites are also moving. So all this is done through an electronic steering, which we have developed, and we also have patented some of the design of these antennas, which were called electronically steered phased array antennas.
So how soon can this product be commercialized?
This antenna is being, as I mentioned, presently tested over satellite. We expect it to be on the market next year. And as you know, SpaceX and Amazon and Telesat and many others are working on multiple constellations of these low Earth orbit satellites, which will all require this type of technology to track these moving satellites. And what we are adding to it is the ability to also move these antennas on vehicles and also on planes and other movable structures so that they can track multiple satellites while they are in motion at the same time as they are in motion. So we are doing some testing now, and we will have some results announced of these tests, and we hope to be in production sometime next year.
Exciting stuff. I do want to get to your financials, which you did address at the top. You had brought in just over $6 million for the year in 2020, compared to just over $13 million or just under $14 million in 2019. So how did the coronavirus pandemic affect the company?
Well, it affected it fairly badly last year. One of the main reasons was that nothing was, it was not possible to really ship anything, because most of the commercial airlines that carry 50% of the cargo were grounded. Obviously, nobody was flying, so planes were not flying. And so we had millions of dollars worth of equipment sitting on the floor from customers who ordered them and paid for it, but we could not deliver it because there was no way to get them to these countries around the world where we sell this product. So it was a fairly bad year, but we only lost just under $100,000. We still keep paying dividends, even though we have lost $100,000 last year. But this particular year looks much better because we already started out with a very, very strong first quarter where we had a very large order from Japan for 100 of our Manpack terminals that are antennas that you can carry on your back and deploy without any tools within a few minutes. So they automatically can be used as a transmit receive station, and they're used by cellular companies for disaster management. So the company that we sold it to has bought 100 last year, and they bought another 100 this year. So that's our first quarter has been extremely strong.
So are you expecting this first quarter traction to continue into the rest of the year?
We expect that we will have a much better year than last year based on this first quarter. But, you know, our first quarter are generally quite weak, and then we build the second, third, and fourth quarter is the strongest. So this is an anomaly in a sense that the first quarter has been extremely strong, and we hope that the subsequent quarters will pick up, and we will end the year much better than we did last year.
Looking forward to following the story. Leslie, it was great to meet you. Thanks for the time.
My pleasure, Christine. It was a pleasure speaking to you.